Chapter 16 Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila Sanatan Goswami. Once Srila Sanatan Goswami traveled alone from Mathura to Purushottam Dham by way of Jharkhand forest. Because he had been fasting and drinking contaminated water, he had contracted a skin disease on the way. Pained by the disease and feeling himself unfit to serve Sriman Mahaprabhu, he thought, "When I reach Jagannath Puri, I shall give up my body by throwing myself under the wheel of Sri Jagannath Dev's chariot." Upon his arrival there, he went to bhajan place of Srila Haridas Thakur. Haridase kaila teha charana vandan, jani Haridas tare kaila alingan. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antalila 4.14. Upon seeing Srila Haridas Thakur, Srila Sanatan Goswami worshipped his feet. Srila Haridas Thakur, recognizing him, embraced him. When Srila Haridas Thakur observed Srila Sanatan Goswami's eagerness to have darshan of Mahaprabhu, he said, "The Lord will be here very soon." Just at that moment, Sriman Mahaprabhu and his devotees arrived at Srila Haridas Thakur's bhajan sthali to meet with him. Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila Sanatan Goswami offered their full prostrated obeisances to Sriman Mahaprabhu, who lifted Srila Haridas Thakur and embraced him. Haridas kahe, "Sanatan kare namaskar, Sanatan dekhi Prabhu haile chamatkar." Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antalila 4.18. Srila Haridas Thakur said, "O Lord, Sanatan is offering obeisances to you." Sriman Mahaprabhu was astonished to see Srila Sanatan Goswami there and embraced him as well, although Srila Sanatan Goswami repeatedly tried to stop him. Sriman Mahaprabhu then sat on a raised platform with his devotees. Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila Sanatan Goswami sat below at their feet. Sriman Mahaprabhu and Srila Sanatan Goswami then spoke of many things. Sriman Mahaprabhu ordered Srila Sanatan Goswami, "Bhala haila tomar iha haila agmane, ihi ghar rahe iha Haridas sane. Krishna bhakti rase duhu param pradhan, Krishna ras aswadan kare lah Krishna naam." Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antalila 4.48-49. "It is very good that you have come. Stay in this place with Haridas Thakur. You two are most expert in relishing Krishna Bhakti Ras. Both of you stay here together. Relish Shri Krishna's mellows and engage in Krishna Nam Kirtan. Suicide is forbidden." On another day, Sriman Mahaprabhu suddenly said to Srila Sanatan Goswami, "Acts such as suicide are steeped in the mode of ignorance. One can never attain Krishna Prem by committing suicide. Giving up this ignorant idea and always engage in hearing, shravan and chanting, kirtan, very soon you shall attain the wealth of Krishna Prem." Srila Sanatan Goswami was amazed to hear the Lord's words. "The all-knowing Sriman Mahaprabhu disapproves of my intent to commit suicide," he thought, "so he is forbidding me to do so." Srila Sanatan Goswami asked the Lord, "What will you gain by keeping me alive?" Sriman Mahaprabhu replied, "You have surrendered to me, and so now your body is mine. Why do you want to destroy my property? Are you unable to discriminate between right and wrong? Your body is an important instrument through which I will accomplish many tasks. It is through you that I will elucidate the principles of the bhaktas. It is through you that I will elucidate the principles, means the tattvas of the bhaktas, bhakti and Krishna Prem, describe Vaishnava duties and behavior, excavate lost places of pilgrimage, and teach about renunciation. I want you to do all this in my dearmost abode, Mathura Vrindavan. On the order of my mother, I am staying here in Nilachal, and so I cannot go there to teach religious principles, dharma. I want to accomplish all these tasks through the medium of your body, and yet you want to give up that body. How can I tolerate this?
Haridas kahe prabhu, suno Haridas, parer dravye iho chahena karita vinash, parer sthape dravye kena khai bhilaye, nisheda ihare jena na kare anyaye.
Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Antalila 4.87-88. Shriman Mahaprabhu said to Srila Haridas Thakur, "Listen, Haridas, this Sanatan wants to destroy another's property. One who is entrusted with another's property does not embezzle or destroy it. Do not allow him to do such an unlawful thing."
Haridas kahe, "Mithya abhiman kari, tomar gambira hide bujete na pari. Kon kon kare tumi kare kon dravve, tumi na janile keh janite na pare. इतादृश तुमि इहारे करियाछे अंगीकार एता सौभाग्य इहा ना हय कहार।
श्री चैतन्य चेतामित अंतलीला 4.89-91। शिला हरिदास ठाकुर सेड, "माय लॉर्ड, आई फॉल्सली प्राइड माई सेल्फ इन नोइंग योर हार्ट, बट इन ट्रूथ आई एम अनेबल टू अंडरस्टैंड योर डीप इंटेंशंस. नो वन कैन नो योर वर्क्स or through whom you accomplish them, unless you enlighten that person."
In contrast to ordinary conditioned souls, who become frustrated and envious upon hearing a great leader glorifying someone of a lower rank, the open-hearted and virtuous Srila Haridas Thakur said, "O Lord, who can be so fortunate as to be accepted in a way you have accepted Sanatan?"
Shriman Mahaprabhu embraced Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila Sanatan Goswami. He then left to bathe and perform other noontime duties.
Srila Sanatan Goswami's good fortune. Sanatan kahe Haridas kari alangan, tumar bhagyar sima na jai kathan. Tumar deha kahen prabhu mor nij dhan, tuma sama bhagyavan nahi kaun jan. Nij dehe je kare ना पारेन करीते से कार्य करीबे तोमा सेहा मथुराएते जे कार्यते चाहे ईश्वर से सिद्ध है तुम्हार सौभाग्य ए कहिलो निश्चय भक्ति सिद्धांत शास्त्र आचार निर्णय तोमा द्वारे करीबेन बुझेलो आशय हमारे ए देह प्रभु कार्य न लागीला भारत भूमि ते जन्मी ए देह व्यर्थ हैला
सनातन कहे तोमा सम केवा आछे आन महाप्रभु गने तुमी महाभाग्यवान।
श्री चैतन्य चेतामित अंतलीला 4.93-99।
शिला हरिदास ठाकुर अम्ब्रेस शिला सनातन गोस्वामी एंड सेड, "ओ सनातन, नो वन कैन असर्टेन द लिमिट ऑफ योर गुड फॉर्चून. द लॉर्ड कंसिडर्स योर बॉडी टू बी हिज ओन वेल्थ. No one can be as fortunate as you. Through the medium of your body, Shivan Mahaprabhu will accomplish works that he cannot accomplish with his own, and that too in his dearmost abode, Mathura Vrindavan. Whatever Bhagwan wants to accomplish must surely come to pass. This indeed is your supreme good fortune. Through you, Shivan Mahaprabhu will compose treatise on the conclusive truths of bhakti, Bhakti Siddhanta, and the course of proper Vaishnav conduct gleaned from the scriptures. This is the Lord's desire. Sanatan, this body of mine is unfit to be used in the Lord's service, although I have taken birth in Bharat Bhumi, means India. My life has passed in vain."
Srila Sanatan Goswami replied, "Who can be more fortunate than you? You are the most fortunate of all Shriman Mahaprabhu's devotees."
Srila Haridas Thakur's good fortune. Avatar kare Prabhu nama prachare, se nija kare Prabhu kare na tomar dware. Pratya kare teen laksh nama sankirtan, sabare aage kare namer mahima kathan. Apne achare ke na kare prachar, prachar kare na ke ना करें आचार
आचार प्रचार नामे करहे दुई कार्जे, तुमी सर्व गुरु तुमी जगत आर्जे। श्री चैतन्य चितामृत अंत लीला 4.100-203। One of Sriman Mahaprabhu's mission is to propagate the glories of Harinam. He is doing this work through you. Every day you chant 3 lakhs of holy name and sing the glories of Sri Nam to everyone. Some people practice bhakti without preaching it, while others preach bhakti without practicing it themselves. Because you chant pure Harinam, you are an acharya, one who teaches by example. Through your own loud chanting, you initiate the people of this world into Nam Yajna, wholesale dedication to chanting the holy name, and thus you are a preacher. You are therefore guru of all and are worshipable for the entire world. In this way, Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila Sanatan Goswami live together and relish the many varieties of ras present within the topics of Sri Krishna. Sri Jagdanand Pandit's advice. Whenever Sriman Mahaprabhu saw Sri Sanatan Goswami, he forcefully embraced him. This distressed Srila Sanatan Goswami at heart. So one day, he inquired from Sri Jagdanand Pandit about his duty in this matter. Sri Jagdanand Pandit advised him to return to Vrindavan after the Rath Yatra festival. When Sriman Mahaprabhu heard about this, he scolded Sri Jagdanand Pandit and established Srila Sanatan Goswami as his superior. Sriman Mahaprabhu said to Srila Sanatan Goswami, "You are a pure devotee. It is improper for you to think of your body as auspicious or inauspicious. It is especially inappropriate for me, being a sannyasi, to maintain such a consideration." Haridas kahe, "Prabhu je kahila tumi, ei bhaye प्रत्रारण नहीं माने आमी। हरिदास कहे, "प्रभु जे कहिला तुमी, ए बाये प्रत्रारण नहीं माने आमी। अमा सबे अधमे जे करियाचे अंगीकार, दीन दयालु गुण तुमार ताहिते प्रचार। श्री चैतन्य चितामृत अंत लीला 4.181-182। हेरिंग श्रीमन महाप्रभुज वर्ड, Srila Haridas Thakur said, "O Lord, you speak in this way only to deceive us. I do not accept these words of yours. Your quality of being compassionate to the fallen is indicated by the fact that you have accepted such fallen souls as us." A Vaishnava body is never material. Prabhu Hasi kahe, "Shuno Haridas Sanatan, Tattva kahi toma vishe, अमारे जे अच्छे मन, तुम्हारे लाले अपना के लालक अभिमान, लालक के रे लाले नहीं दोष परिज्ञान, अपना रे है मोर अमान्य समान, तोमा सवारे करो मोई बालक अभिमान। श्री चैतन्य चेतामृत अंत लीला 4.183-185। श्रीमन महाप्रभु स्माइल्ड एंड सेड, "Listen, Haridas and Sanatan, I am speaking my heart's feeling for both of you. I consider you as boys and myself as your guardian. The guardian never sees the faults of his dependents. Due to my love and affection for you, my devotees, I never considered myself to be worthy of your respect or worship. I simply see you all as my children." Haridas kahe, "Tumi Ishwar Dayamai, तुम्हार गंभीर हृदय बुझिना न जाए, वासुदेव गलत कुश्ती ताते अंग खीड़ामय, तारे अलिंगन कैला हैल सदाए, अलिंगन कैला तार कंदर्प सम अंग, बुझिते ना पारी तुम्हार कृपा तरंग। प्रभु कहे, वैष्णव दे प्राकृत कबु नय, अप्राकृत दे भक्तिर चिदानंदमय, दीक्षा काले भक्त करे आत्मसमर्पण, सही काले कृष्ण तार करे आत्मसम, से देह करे तार चिदानंदमय, अप्राकृत देह तार चरण भजय। श्री चैतन्य चितामृत अंत लीला 4.188-193। Hearing Shriman Mahaprabhu's words, Srila Haridas Thakur said, "You are the most merciful Supreme Lord. No one can understand the gravity of your heart." The Brahmin Vasudev was suffering from an aggravated case of leprosy, and a morbid discharge oozed from his body, which was infested with worms. When you mercifully embraced him, his body became as beautiful as Cupid's. Yet after you repeatedly embracing Sri Sanatan, however, his disease remains. Therefore, who can understand the waves of your mercy? Shriman Mahaprabhu said, "O Haridas, a Vaishnava's body is never material, but transcendental and full of spiritual bliss. At the time of initiation, Diksha, a devotee surrenders at the lotus feet of Bhagwan through the medium of Sri Guru. Sri Krishna then makes him transcendental like himself. The Lord does not give him another body, but spiritualizes that very body. With that spiritual body, the devotee then serves the Lord. Sanatanar Deh Krishna Kandu Upajai Ama Parikshate Iha Dila Pathai Ghrina Kari Alingan Na Kari Tam Jave Krishna Thai Aparadi Hai Tam Tave Parishad Deh Ei Na Hai Durgan Pratham Divase Pailu Chatu Sam Gand." Shri Chaitanya Chaitamrit Anta Lila 4.195-197. "O Haridas, in order to test me, Sri Krishna manifested the skin disease in Sanatana's body and sent him here. If I had felt repulsed by his skin condition and failed to embrace him, I would have become an offender to Sri Krishna. Sanatana is an associate of the Lord. How is it possible for his body to emit a foul odor? How is it possible for his body to emit a foul odor? When I first embraced him, I smelled the fragrance of chatusam, means a mixture of sandalwood, musk, saffron and agru." Turning towards Srila Sanatana Goswami, Mahaprabhu then said, "Sanatana, do not feel any sorrow. Embracing you fills me with joy." Shriman Mahaprabhu said that the Lord manifested this disease in Srila Sanatana Goswami and sent him to Nilachal in order to test him. Yet in reality, it seems that Shriman Mahaprabhu was the one testing Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila Sanatana Goswami with various trials, which they both fully passed. Thus, at the day's end, Shriman Mahaprabhu again embraced Srila Sanatana Goswami. That day, Srila Sanatana Goswami's disease vanished and his body became as radiant as gold. "Dekhi Haridas mane haila chamatkar, Prabhur kahin ei bhangi je tomar, se jari khandir pani tumi khohayula, se pani lakshe ihar kandu upajila, kandu kari pariksha karela sanatane, ए लीला भंगी तुमार केह नहीं जाने। श्री चैतन्य चेतामृत अंत लीला 4.202-204। Witnessing this pastime of Shriman Mahaprabhu, Srila Haridas Thakur was struck with wonder. He said, "O Lord, this is simply your pastime. You made Sanatana drink the water from the Jharikhand forest, which caused itchy sores to form on his body. Through this disease, you tested him. No one can understand the mysterious nature of your pastimes." Shriman Mahaprabhu embraced Srila Haridas Thakur and again embraced Srila Sanatana Goswami. When he had departed for his residence, Srila Haridas Thakur and Srila Sanatana Goswami, enraptured in prem, sang his transcendental qualities. In this way, Srila Sanatana Goswami stayed in Nilachal for many days. Together with Srila Haridas Thakur, he continually relished narrations of Shriman Mahaprabhu's qualities.